Good morning, Wildcats. It's my back hosting with my friend.
Hi, it's Kenya, and we are back. How's your spring break, Samaya?
It was great, but short.
That's for sure.
Please stand for the pledge.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The story of the Exodus is a classic. Moses, Pharaoh, blood, frogs, hail, the splitting of the sea, and the liberation of an enslaved nation from their oppressors. This is what we celebrate during the springtime holiday of Passover, also called Pesach. After some extreme house cleaning, we sit down to eat matzah, bitter herbs, drink 4 cups of wine, ask 4 questions, tell lots of stories, and eat charoset made out of apples and nuts. But when we get down to it all, what really is Passover? And why do we celebrate it? It's a long story how we got down to Egypt, but let's just say some rainbow coats and sibling rivalries were involved. The Jewish people, all 70 of them, descended down to Egypt. And there they stayed as shepherds, and then as slaves. And they had kids, like lots of kids. Pharaoh didn't take kindly to this. The Egyptians treated us badly. They made the Jews work hard with bricks and mud. They threw the Jewish baby boys into the Nile. But one baby boy, named Moses, was miraculously saved, and even raised in Pharaoh's home. After some wild adventures involving escaping from Egypt, marriage, and a burning bush, Moses was instructed by God to take the people out of Egypt. Pharaoh refused, and so came the 10 plagues. The last plague was the worst of them all, the death of the firstborn. But before that happened, God commanded the Jews to offer a lamb or goat, which the Egyptians worshipped as one of their gods, and smear its blood on the doorposts and lintel of their home. Seeing the blood and the brave devotion it signified, God slew the firstborn Egyptians, passing over the homes of the Jews. That's where the word Passover comes from. And now, in every generation, we're obligated to view ourselves as if we went out of Egypt. You see, the Exodus isn't just some event that happened thousands of years ago, or even just an annual commemoration on Passover. It's something we're meant to experience throughout the year and every day of our lives.
Ramadan is a special month to millions of Muslims around the world. It begins at the first sight of the new moon of the 9th month of the Islamic calendar. During Ramadan, many Muslims fast by not eating or drinking from dawn until sunset. Muslims get up before dawn and have a meal called suhoor and then won't eat or drink again until sunset. Then they will break their fast, usually with water and dates and a meal called iftar. Muslims believe that fasting helps them understand the needs of the poor and those without food. It's also a time to draw closer to Allah or God through prayer, giving to charity and reading the Quran, the Muslim holy book. Ramadan lasts for around 30 days and finishes with a huge celebration called Eid al-Fitr. On this day, Muslims usually attend Eid prayers and have a feast with family and friends. Gifts are often given too.
Weather report. On Monday, the highs will be 73, the low will be 53 degrees. On Tuesday, the highs will be 68, the low will be 52. On Wednesday, the highs will be 67, and the low will be 51. On Thursday, the highs will be 68, the low will be 52. On Friday, the highs will be 69, the low will be 52 degrees. Most of the week will be partly cloudy.
What made me got into art was my high school teacher, Miss Magnet, so she got me into art so much. What I like to draw is Marvel characters. I like to draw Disney too, so my favorite one is Pinocchio that I like to draw the most. My biggest accomplishment is the school first credit union at the bank. That was my first big ever one. Now it's at the Esperanza Library, and Miss Magnet put it all together, and I really love her, so she's great. My future plan is to go on Jimmy Fallon because he's my favorite host of The Tonight Show. So that's my biggest one. What inspires me is, like, I looked up on YouTube and this guy named Cartoony Club, he is amazing. He does, like, extra big drawings, so that got me into drawing.
May the 4th be with you. Nerd History. This is a common pun heard every year at the beginning of May, marking the official Star Wars Day. But our younger nerds might not realize that this is a relatively new celebration. In 2011, the first organized celebration of Star Wars Day took place in Toronto, Ontario, Canada, at the Toronto Underground Cinema. Festivities included an original trilogy trivia game show, a costume contest with celebrity judges, and the web's best tribute films, mashups, parodies, and remixes on the big screen. The second annual edition took place on Friday, May 4th, 2012, to much the same fanfare. But after 2 years of indie success, in 2013 it became official, as Disney celebrated the holiday as well, with several Star Wars events and festivities at both Disneyland and Walt Disney World.
This is Venture Adventures.
Bye!
Bye, guys.
I have you!